Hello and welcome everyone, this is XDA-Dante63, I hope you all are doing great. I bring you a big, massive and amazing update on the SHM MOD Companion. As you guys know, SHM MOD Companion used to be a very simple tool that would provide the latest version of the mods from my Google Drive. It helped in enabling the BP sync, it also had other sections to read from, such as permissions using the SHM Companion, frequently asked questions about the mod and what is new, and not to mention the watch section for WearOS, which basically checks for updates if there are any. But now the tool is capable of doing so much more, and guys, I'm so excited to share that with you, so let's dive in. The first thing you would notice is an auto update. By default, it is set to 7 days, and you can set it to 3 days or set to never. That is completely in your hands. I was thinking of making it longer, but then I realized if the auto check update was triggered and the next day I released a patch, then the update will surely be missed until the next auto update check is triggered. So I said 7 days is the best. And the best thing about the auto check updates, it has no impact on battery. Now the next thing, guys, right over here is the download mechanism. So as you know that it's downloading, or the files are on my Google Drive, and you used to just tap on, then you open either in the browser or you try to open it in the Google Drive app, but now that's not the case. You can download directly using the application. You simply just select the file, you hit the download, enjoy watching this adorable cute spinning cat around till your download is complete. Once the download is complete, you'll have the option to install or dismiss. So if you hit on the install, you select the package, you grant the permission, so let's just go right over here, allow from source, and you hit the install. Otherwise, you dismiss. So that's the second thing you guys would notice. Now scrolling down, you'll see that I have put two apps as other apps. These apps are developed by me. In case you don't know, on the Play Store, my developer name is Gemini Man. Right. With that being said, back to these two apps. On the left, you will see Gemini Man Watch Faces Case. This app crawls the Play Store and gets all the watch faces I've developed. And on the right is Gemini Man WearOS Manager. It is a very powerful tool to perform ADB commands from your phone to your watch. It is possible to use this tool with any device that supports debug over Wi-Fi. You just will have few abilities and limitations in the usage since the app was developed for watch. Nevertheless, from the WearOS manager, I was able to improve the SHM MOD Companion, and to be precise, by going into the watch section. A complete makeover has been done. You can check for updates and get the watch IP address. So right now in this section, you'll have the enabling the developer options explanation about all of this. Watch icon with a question mark, or IP address of the watch, the same thing, question mark, it will give you the same dialogue. Right, with your watch ADB debug enabled and debug over Wi-Fi, and watch is connected to actual Wi-Fi, so you click on the get the watch IP, you'll get the watch IP, you say proceed, it sets the watch IP address, you want to check for updates, you tap on the check for updates, you get watch updates from your watch. You get the version and all, it says what you have. You want to connect, you tap on the connect, it gives you a Bluetooth notice, it's recommended to have your Bluetooth switched off, but if you want, you can proceed with the Bluetooth connected, but if you find any interruption, you can turn off the Bluetooth and try connecting. So I'll hit on the I understand and proceed. So it's going to try to ping the IP address, it says confirmation, there is a device with such IP, please keep your eyes on the watch or incoming connections prompt and set it to always, since this is your phone, you're installing and connecting from to your watch. So you check and have a look at the watch, my watch is not prompting because I already granted a permission. You can see the activity log is always giving you constant updates on what has been done. Now what you can do here is you can sideload the APK file, but the sideloading is limited only to two applications, the SHM MOD Companion and the SHM Watch MOD. You can only sideload these things. If you want to sideload anything else, you can use the WearOS Manager. Now with the click of a button, you can remove the Samsung Health Monitor, the original one, and you can restore it. If you would notice that it's taking a bit of time and doing operations, just turn on your watch screen and boom, command is received. It's most likely because of the watch going into idle mode, so it does not perform any operations. Now if I'm going to hit on the restore to restore the stock SHM, And there you go. Now I will disconnect the command. It will just pop a message. Don't forget to turn off ADB debugging and debug over Wi-Fi on the watch. Okay, so on your watch, you will have basically, you have your watch ADB debug and debug over Wi-Fi are both turned on and the watch is connected to Wi-Fi. So we just go to the companion and basically right over here, you would notice that your watch is connected to an IP address. The version of the watch is for the SHM mod is this and the companion is that. Activity logs showing standby. So even without the application turned on, as soon as you say, for example, check for updates, it will open the application and get the details. And you can literally see that it will close the application on your behalf to prevent any battery consumption. So this is kind of a very straightforward and automated way. Now getting the watch IP, same way I can get the watch IP and then I just on my phone hit the proceed and the application on the watch will close as soon as it's done. BP Sync is the same, nothing has changed in it. SHM MOD frequently asked questions at the bottom, can I do this from my phone? This section has been changed to have the Gemini WearOS manager or to use the companion itself to do the side loading and so on. The SHM MOD features right over here, guys, the only change has been done is removing about the themes and all, because Samsung has finally implemented a dark theme mode on the Samsung Health Monitor application. App permissions, you got the Bluetooth, so I can check for the Bluetooth if it's on or off and pop up the message for you guys. What is new is something else that has been changed. I have added a YouTube player for the SHM MOD companion and for the SHM MOD itself. What is new? So now, not only you will be reading, but if you want to watch and learn more about what is new in these versions, you can check it out in the YouTube video. And that's pretty much all, guys. Thank you very much for watching. These changes, I hope they will improve your experience in getting things done on your WearOS watch. Tizen users, I am very sorry. Watch 3 and Active 2 to be precise. You still have to use the PC to create and sign the mod with the certificates before choosing whatever method that you'd like to use to install the mod on your watch. Thank you very much for watching, guys. Don't forget, your support is greatly appreciated to keep me going and making great apps, mods, and things for you guys to enjoy using. Have a great day. Cheers.